After nearly two decades of relentless research and development, the Dream Chaser is poised to make its first impact on the space race. So when will this momentous event occur, and what will it look like? Let's dive deeper on today's episode of NR Studio. The Space Shuttle Atlantis in 2011 marked the closing chapter of a pivotal era in space exploration. While the program had grown into a highly complex and financially demanding undertaking, its retirement left a significant gap in human capacity to conduct critical operations in low Earth orbit. The shuttle's incredible ability to carefully return payloads to Earth was unmatched, allowing researchers immediate access to sensitive experiments immediately after landing on the runway. For three decades, the system has consistently supported scientific progress and innovation. However, its retirement has deprived researchers of this critical resource. While SpaceX's Dragon spacecraft remains the preferred choice for such missions, the procedures involved in its return, coupled with NASA's central operations, often hinder the efficient conduct of scientific research. SpaceX has improved its schedule through the integration of helicopter transport. However, it still can't match the efficiency of the space shuttle. As SpaceX has halted its efforts toward precision propulsion landings for its Dragon spacecraft, it suggests that other entities will have to step up to meet the demands of rapid payload recovery. Serendipitously, this aligns perfectly with the aspirations of Sierra Nevada Corporation for their Dream Chaser spacecraft. The Dream Chaser is an advanced winged, lifting body spacecraft that possesses the capability to land on any runway globally, provided it measures a minimum of 10,000 feet in length. Following the retirement of the shuttle program, the Dream Chaser emerged as the sole NASA-funded spacecraft possessing atmospheric maneuverability. Following over a decade of rigorous research and development, the inaugural flight of Dream Chaser is slated for no earlier than May of the upcoming year. Although it is somewhat behind schedule in relation to the company's previous declarations, the flight continues to be one of the most eagerly awaited events among the space enthusiast community. The inaugural mission of the Dream Chaser will showcase the spacecraft designated as Tenacity, in tandem with a supplementary cargo module referred to as Shooting Star. It is projected to transport 12,000 pounds, approximately equal to the weight of two Ford F-150 trucks, to the International Space Station. The cargo may encompass a diverse range of items, including sustenance, hydration, and essential provisions for astronauts, as well as scientific apparatus and replacement components for the station. The absence of a crew allows for the maximization of available space within Tenacity, optimizing it for meticulously arranged cargo. While this iteration of the spacecraft is devoid of windows, Angie Wise, Senior Vice President of Safety and Mission Assurance at Sierra Space, indicated that the majority of cargo loading is scheduled to commence 30 days prior to the launch. Nevertheless, NASA's contract stipulates that live cargo, cold storage bags, and other temperature-sensitive equipment may be loaded as much as 48 hours prior to launch. Our team has taken to calling it professional Tetris, as my wife aptly noted. At our Louisville facility, we not only instruct our personnel on the procedures for loading and unloading our vehicles, we also engage astronaut crews in immersive training to master the reception of our vehicle, the operation of the hatch, and the efficient handling of cargo. Although initiated at the International Space Station, the operation to unload and reload Tenacity is projected to require approximately 35 to 75 days. The daily allocation of crew time designated for the unloading and reloading process is constrained. The crews of the ISS will additionally load items designated for destruction onto a shooting star, which will refrain from making the return journey to Earth. Upon Tenacity's detachment from the ISS and subsequent initiation of its deorbit burn, the cargo module will separate from Tenacity and incinerate upon reentry, along with its contents. How will the space plan establish a link with the International Space Station? Following the completion of their final environmental testing at Armstrong, Tenacity and Shooting Star will be transported by NASA to Kennedy, where preparations for launch, including loading, will commence. Tenacity is securing its place in low Earth orbit, nestled within a 5-meter payload fairing on ULA's Vulcan rocket. Below are the primary stages of Tenacity's mission to and from the ISS. Although Sierra Space's Dream Chaser is designed to land on expansive commercial runways, NASA has specifically requested that Tenacity land at the shuttle landing facility at Kennedy. This preference facilitates the more efficient retrieval of cargo hardware and sensitive scientific experiments by crews. As articulated by Matt Clark, Chief Brand Officer and Senior Vice President of Marketing at Sierra Space, Florida serves as a quintessential locale for these missions. Upon arriving in Florida, we can swiftly offload the cargo and gain immediate access, thereby distinguishing ourselves from current alternatives. Unlike landing in an ocean, this approach facilitates expedient retrieval without excessive delay, he stated. That represents a significant distinction in terms of our offerings. Wise observed that the multitude of proprietary foam-like thermal tiles adorning Dream Chaser enables the spacecraft to rapidly dissipate heat post-landing, thereby enhancing the efficiency of unloading time-sensitive cargo. Although re-entry temperatures can soar to 3,000 degrees, Tenacity cools sufficiently within a mere 30 minutes, allowing us to safely approach the vehicle and retrieve all cargo and equipment, she remarked. However, this merely marks the inception of what Dream Chaser is poised to accomplish in the future. In the meantime, Sierra Space is actively developing its second cargo spacecraft, Reverence. Reverence, designated as DC-102, is anticipated to require an additional 18 months for completion prior to the readiness of the second spacecraft. Alongside its cargo fleet, Sierra Space is advancing the development of a crewed variant of the spacecraft designated as the DC-200 series, as well as a national security variant referred to as the DC-300. This underscores the substantial demand for this multifaceted spacecraft, what renders it a particularly enticing asset. Below are five attributes that distinguish Sierra Nevada's spacecraft as an invaluable enhancement to the nation's space infrastructure. Adaptability. Dream Chaser exhibits a remarkable versatility, making it suitable for a diverse array of applications. The launch site, landing site, vehicle configuration, mission duration, and various other attributes can be tailored to accommodate the requirements of a wide range of users. Due to its reliance on non-toxic fuel and the lack of need for specialized infrastructure, it has the capability to land on aircraft runways in virtually any location. This provides a multitude of benefits. For instance, by ensuring the prompt and secure delivery of payloads and astronauts returning from space to their ultimate destinations. Capability. Despite measuring merely a quarter of the length of the space shuttle, Dream Chaser boasts a superior carrying capacity compared to the other spacecraft utilized in NASA's commercial resupply program. Fitted with an expendable cargo module, it possesses the capacity to transport 6 tons to low Earth orbit, sufficient to sustain astronauts aboard the ISS for a duration of 6 months. Nearly all of that 6 tons is transported under pressurized conditions. Additionally, it possesses the capability to return 2 tons of cargo, encompassing delicate scientific experiments, attributable to its relatively gentle gravitational loading during re-entry and touchdown. The spacecraft can accommodate a maximum of 7 astronauts. Reusability. The foundational NASA design that inspired Dream Chaser prioritized cost-effective access to space. SNC has engineered the space plane for a maximum of 15 operational flights. The principle of reusability is crucial for minimizing expenses associated with space missions, and Dream Chaser offers a higher frequency of reuse compared to other spacecraft utilized by NASA for missions to the International Space Station. The durability and operational lifespan of the vehicle are enhanced by its design, which allows for minimal gravitational stress and a smooth landing. Habitability. SNC initially designed Dream Chaser for crewed missions to the space station, aligning with NASA's original intent for the vehicle, rather than prioritizing cargo missions. The unmanned cargo variant of Dream Chaser closely resembles its crewed counterpart, indicating its inherent adaptability for the transportation of astronauts. Environmental controls, life support systems, and seating arrangements are crucial for facilitating a crewed mission, while a horizontal landing capability significantly mitigates the impact on astronauts re-entering Earth after extended periods in orbit. Adaptability. All the previously mentioned attributes collectively render Dream Chaser the most adaptable spacecraft currently funded by NASA. In addition to its capability of transporting cargo and personnel, it is adept at executing a diverse range of missions, including microgravity research, remote sensing activities, and the servicing of deployed satellites. It holds the potential for application in both civilian and military operations, and with the implementation of radiation hardening, it may be employed in elevated orbits. Moreover, it can be elevated into orbit utilizing an array of launch vehicles, including those rated for human transport, should the choice be made to employ it for astronaut conveyance. If SNC's historical precedent serves as an indicator, this represents merely the initial chapter in the Dream Chaser narrative. The origins of Dream Chaser are deeply embedded in a narrative from the Cold War period, reminiscent of a thrilling espionage tale. In 1982, a reconnaissance aircraft of the Australian Air Force documented images of a Soviet trawler seemingly retrieving what appeared to be a spacecraft from the ocean. These images were disseminated to the CIA, prompting subsequent notification to NASA. Leveraging the photographs as a reference, NASA engineers executed a remarkable endeavor in reverse engineering to fabricate a model of the Soviet Borofors spacecraft. This initiative ultimately resulted in the conception of a horizontal landing spacecraft known as the HL-20. The HL-20 was conceived as a reusable spacecraft designed to facilitate the transport of astronauts to and from orbital space stations. A comprehensive mock-up of the HL-20 remains on display at the Wings Over the Rockies Air and Space Museum in Colorado. Nevertheless, despite its potential, the HL-20 initiative was ultimately abandoned around 1995 as a result of changing priorities within NASA. In 2006, Sierra Nevada Corporation, SNC, recognized the latent possibilities within the inactive design. The company has suggested reinvigorating the HL-20 concept and enhancing its design. As articulated by Steve Lindsay, a former NASA astronaut and currently a senior executive at SNC, we extensively refined NASA's original design to culminate in the Dream Chaser that you observe today. The spacecraft, currently a pivotal element of SNC's aerospace initiatives, evolves from the foundational design of the HL-20, seamlessly integrating contemporary innovations and technologies. It is noteworthy that Dream Chaser's Soviet roots have reached a point of complete circumscription, given that NASA is currently engaged in collaboration with the Russian Space Agency. The U.S. engineers have engaged in discussions regarding the Borofors legacy with their Russian counterparts. Lindsay observes that Russian engineers exhibited considerable enthusiasm regarding the advancement of their technology into a cutting-edge spacecraft akin to Dream Chaser. He noted their enthusiasm regarding our advancement to the next level. SNC's endeavors with the Dream Chaser have not only propelled advancements in spacecraft technology, but have also provided valuable insights for other ambitious initiatives, such as the Lunar Gateway. This joint initiative by NASA seeks to establish a permanent lunar outpost, serving as a crucial launch pad for advanced space exploration, including prospective missions to Mars. SNC's expertise in satellite systems related to propulsion and environmental control has played a critical role in the Gateway project's progress. Steve Lindsay's association with SNC underscores Dream Chaser's enormous potential. A seasoned astronaut with 5 space flights, Lindsay embarked on his maiden mission aboard Space Shuttle Discovery in 2011, coinciding with the program's endgame. Discovery's illustrious tenure featured a landmark mission in 1998 that saw John Glenn, at age 77, achieve the distinction of being the oldest person to travel to space, a mission expertly led by Lindsay. After retiring from NASA in 2011, Lindsay, who had held prestigious positions as chief of the astronaut corps and managed operations of the International Space Station, pursued a new venture. He founded at SNC. During my interview, I essentially took the vehicle apart to determine what the problem was, Lindsay recalled. I didn't find anything compelling and concluded that they had a sound concept. I was looking for an environment where I could use my accumulated knowledge and make a meaningful contribution. In his interview, SNC executives asked thought-provoking questions. Could he be considering piloting Dream Chaser? Initially taken aback, Lindsay quickly dismissed the notion, stating her belief that the opportunity should have gone to a younger astronaut. However, Lindsay acknowledged that we were reminded of John Glenn's historic flight at age 77. That was certainly accurate. If John had been present, I am sure he would have expressed a desire to pilot it. Indeed, Lindsay recalled Glenn articulating his enthusiasm for Dream Chaser, saying that he expressed a desire to pilot it. Dream Chaser, steeped in historical narrative and poised for a bright future, serves as a bridge between the world of space exploration, the legacy of the Cold War, and the frontiers of discovery to come. In anticipation of its upcoming operational mission, the spacecraft symbolizes innovation, collaboration, and humanity's relentless aspiration to explore the cosmos. This concludes today's episode. I appreciate your presence and look forward to our next meeting.